Hello guys, welcome to another Maya tutorial, and in this video I'm gonna be creating this kind of cool volumetric light. So I'm gonna get started right away. So first of all, I'm gonna create a simple interior scene. If you already have your model, you can skip this. So I'm gonna just create a simple box shape and grab my knife tool and cut it several times. I'm gonna create windows like that using the extrude tool, and there we go, and we can delete that. And finally select that. Before that, I wanna bridge this out to fill it. Bridge, and now finally we can select the hole and have a little bit of thickness there, like so. Something got real little wrong there. Okay, now I created my scene. And before I render this out, I'm gonna add a skydome light. Now we have that. And go out to the render view, and if you run it, now you can see this kind of interior scene. But what I want is cool volumetric light. I want a volumetric atmosphere. The volumetric shadows are coming in. So to do so, it's quite simple. We can go to the Arnold render setting here. If you scroll down there, you can see the environment tab, and you can simply go to atmosphere, and you can create a AI atmosphere volume. After that, you can go to the attribute. You can add a density like 0.1, and if we render this out again, for some reason you cannot see anything. So we should create another light for the atmosphere. So what I'm gonna use is a spotlight. You can use the AI area light, but I prefer to use spotlight personally. So you can rotate it and give it a little directional, and we can use higher intensity like 5. Let's go over to Arnold tab. You can see a lot of things, but I want to use the light for volume only, so we can remove every other visibility except the volume. So if we go to the render view again, basically there's nothing. So let's hide the skydome light temporarily to see how the volume looks like. So we can see a little bit of it, but not very noticeable. So what we can do is can go to the spotlight attribute again. We can increase the intensity, and there's a lot of settings we can tweak there, like cone angle there, and can tweak the angles like that. And there's a drop off. Maybe we should use higher intensity there. Now we are starting seeing something. Let me get a proper camera angle. I think it's too narrow. So I'm gonna create another camera. Let me have a resolution gate there. can select the camera, and we can tweak the focal length to get a wider view. And if you want, you can go to Arnold. There's a cool radial distortion. You can give it a little bit of it. So I got better view. So we started seeing that volumetric light. So let's go with 500 maybe. So now you can see volumetric light is there. So we can now show the skydome light, and let's render this again. Now we can start to tweak the attributes in the skydome light. Maybe we can give the intensity, and I don't want to affect the volume by the skydome light. So that's pretty cool. And one more thing we can do is we can go to render setting again and go to the atmosphere volume attribute, and we can tweak the density. You can see how it changes. Let's go with 0.12, and you can tweak the color, of course, but I want to use the color temperature. So I'm going to select the spotlight again. I'm going to go to Arnold tab again and use color temperature, and I want a little bit of cooler color to give it a more like a futuristic feeling there. We can do the same thing in the skydome light. So it's more like a cold color. So, if you're done, we should increase the sampling to get better render results. So, let me stop this rendering and niche light. You can see the samples under the Arnold tab. This is the AI light is there originally, but in the spotlight or any other legacy lights, you can only see this under the Arnold tab. And I'm going to use 3, or you can go higher if you want better quality, but it takes more time. And you can increase the camera AA sample, and you can keep that, or you can go higher. And there's no transmission in the scene, so we can go to 0 or 1. And we don't have any subsurface scattering. And we have volume indirect. So now we're ready to render. So, and also you can set your resolution this common setting here. I'm gonna go with a 720p. I'm gonna render. So it's gonna take a while, so I'll come back when it's done. Now my rendering is done, and now I'm gonna do a little bit of color correction. So you can do this on a display tab on the right side, but if you can't see anything, you can go to the window menu and you can enable the display settings. So you can tweak the gamma value like that if you want to pop out more of those volumetric light. You can lower the gamma value and add more exposure like that, more like a glowing stare, and is more popping up. So you can take your time and do your color management. But if you do some extremely high exposure value, you can see more noise, as you can see here. So I think I like this. And if you're done with the color management, and you can go to file and save image, but if you save image now, you're not gonna see any difference from the raw image. So to apply the color management, you can go to save image options and you can check on apply gamma and exposure. So you can check on that and close it and save image and choose whatever file type you want, and you can save this. And one more tip is that you can use AOVs inside of render settings. You can choose your volume indirect, and you can compose it in a third-party composing software, and that's up to you. And also inside of atmospheric volume attribute, you can set the attenuation like that, and you can use your color map. For example, you can use a 3D texture for that, and you're gonna see this kind of effect there. It's more like an underwater situation. That's a little trick when you're working on some sort of undersea scene or anything else. So that's it. And what I've done in this video is I created some cool volumetric lights, and I guess it can be really useful when you're working on some kind of atmospheric scene. So hope you guys enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.